Hello, I'm Dr. Sreenivasa Murthy T M, a senior ENT consultant practicing at Yeshwantpur. I practice both at Columbia Asia Referral Hospital as well as at my clinic called Sreenivasa Speciality ENT Center. In allergic rhinitis, that is the allergy of the nose, the common allergens, that is the stimulus which causes allergy, are usually looked for are airborne allergens, which can be dust mite, insect products like cockroaches, it can be animal products, animal dandruff, it can be birds droppings, it can be fungus, pollens. So these are the common things that we look for when we try to find whether somebody is allergic to some thing. The most common reason why somebody has allergic rhinitis is known to be because they are allergic to an insect called as dust mite. Now this exists in your bedroom. Most people with allergic rhinitis, if they recall memory, will find that they tend to sneeze more in their house and bedroom than on the streets. So that itself says that something in the room is what is causing it rather than something in the environment. Everyone who comes to us with allergic rhinitis also asks whether using a mask helps in preventing the load of allergens which enter our nose. The answer is no, because these masks cannot filter out that size particles. So they do tend to cause symptoms despite using masks. So the main fulcrum or the pivot point in allergy is if somebody is allergic, then they need to find out what they're allergic to by doing allergic skin prick tests, or occasionally they can also resort to using blood tests, and then try to identify them in their household. See whether they can prevent the appearance of those allergens in their environment. If it is not possible, then they'll have to be on medication or they will have to undergo a process called as immunotherapy.